Well, it looks like they got enough signs here to tell you how to get there. There's the parking. And
I haven't made a lot of video during this harvest this year because I'm sick. Something has jumped on me.
I fully retired from my job at the cigar shop back in October when I turned 65. So I was kind of excited about being retired and jumping on all these different projects that I had piled up here. And this particular project, I finally went out and bought myself a MIG welder. It's Harbor Freight Titanium MIG 170. Pretty versatile. I'll put a link to the product in the video description for anybody that wants to take a look at it. And I found this little cart, and I couldn't believe it, but the measurements of the cart were actually going to let me take my old stick welder and put it in the bottom of the cart and then put this MIG welder on the top of the cart. And there's a place in the back of the cart for a bottle of gas. But right now I'm pretty much focused on flux core. People that have been around a while might remember about 3 years ago when Cousin Scott brought that cleaner home and it had so much of the sheet metal rusted out of it. He went and bought a little MIG welder, but neither one of us knew anything about it. So we didn't get anywhere with that, and I ended up taking my stick welder. See there, I'm checking that measurement. And there it is, set up. A little tack, just playing with some scrap metal here. Now, I didn't want to bore you with a long run here, so I sped the video up. And this is probably about the 20th or 30th time that I've actually attempted welding. I've actually learned, you know, hold the bead distance and things like that. And as you'll see here in a minute from the visual, I've still got a lot to learn. It's not perfect by no means. If you take a look at the timestamp on the special weather report, you might think that I got up really early. Nah, I've been sitting up all night thinking about my next approach to this medical condition. I've already been taking myself to the hospital now, bypassed the primary care physician, and told them point blank, I've got lung cancer. Let's find it and start a treatment program. The first time they sent me home with antibiotics. I finally got a doctor on the third trip up there to that hospital who was willing to investigate further. And sure enough, she found it. I was really happy about that. You know, uncertainty is not a fun place to be. The doctor decided she wanted to go ahead and admit me to the hospital so that she could run fast-track testing on me, which would take about 3 days. She wanted to establish the baseline to see where we were at. And it looks like we're going to have pretty good internet access while we're up here. The food in this hospital is absolutely fantastic. You use a menu in your room, you place a phone call, you order your meal. 30, 40 minutes later, they bring it to you. And this egg omelet was phenomenal. Pretty much spent the next 3 days being carried to different testing facilities to run these tests to collect the information the doctor wanted to collect. Another fine example of the culinary delights available from the hospital cafeteria. Those little red skin roasted potatoes were delicious. When the dietitian told me she wanted me to drink 3 of these a day, I thought she was kidding. But at that point in time, I didn't have a clue what I was fixing to get into. We're up to January the 9th now. I'm sitting in a waiting room for my second chemotherapy treatment. I've been in radiation treatment for a week, and I still don't really have a clue where I'm headed with all of this.